Hi, everybody. Bob Vorwald from WGN. Welcome to another edition of Len and Bob's podcast. And we're on location today, Len.
I like this. We should broadcast from up here one of these days. This is awesome. What a great treat this is.
We took a little walk out to the Wrigley Field scoreboard today. Fred Washington's our congenial host. And, you know, this could be backup work for you someday.
Oh, I can see myself working in this environment. Yeah, it's a lot like what our booth looks like during the course of a ball game with papers laying around and scores from out-of-town games. But, you know, so many people have seen the scoreboard from the other side, from their seat in the stands. But this is a rare treat to get to go behind the scenes.
It's really fun to kind of be in here, isn't it, Landon?
Well, it's old school. I mean, everything that happens in here is hand done. And, you know, Fred can figure out which game is which. I have no idea. I mean, all I'm seeing is zeros right now. I have no idea how he figures out what game is going on or what inning it is, but it's a pretty amazing thing.
Well, and Fred will tell you the secret is working backwards. He knows how to look at the...
We do know how to do that.
Well, you always say we've got the greatest view in sports, but these guys might argue with you a little bit.
Yeah, theirs is pretty nice, too. We were just talking about it. We've done some games from the bleachers in the past, and, of course, back in the day, Harry used to do games from the center field bleachers. It's a much different perspective from center field than it is from the left field bleachers where we've done games in the past. We'll have to... see if we can work our way out here this year.
So 1937, the original, and it's still here.
It's really amazing. I'd be curious, and we can ask Fred, you know, when the temperature is 60, does it feel 60 in here? I have to imagine when it's 85, it probably feels a little warmer than that, or when it's 35, it feels colder than that. But again, that fits the park because it's kind of similar for us where we are in our booth. But, you know, you can not only see the field, but you can see up the street. It's just fantastic.
Well, let's talk about the Cubs here for a little bit on the podcast. Can Fukudome ever be stopped? Oh, my gosh.
We hope not. We hope not. I mean, there's nothing about his approach that would say he's going to go into an extended slump. I mean, certainly this is Major League Baseball, and guys go through peaks and valleys. But because of his patience, because of his eye for the strike zone, his tremendous hand-eye coordination, he showed us a bunt yesterday. I mean, there really isn't anything he can't do offensively. Now, that being said, he will struggle from time to time. The league will try to figure out how to attack him, and at that point, I have no doubts he'll be able to make the adjustments necessary.
But he can play defense every day, he can run every day, and he seems to know the strike zone every day, and that kind of limits the valleys.
Yeah, you would hope so. I mean, that's kind of been the history of this game. The really, really good players find a way to minimize the slumps and maximize those peaks we were talking about. And like I said, he gives every indication that he has this game pretty well figured out.
And let me add to that, and I'm sure we'll talk about it more on the air, but the way it's been built up, this rock star-like treatment, you might worry about a player who would be seen as streaky or inconsistent, but because of his ability to determine what a strike is and what a ball is, he should be able to give you good at-bats throughout. If you were a streaky player and all of a sudden goes through an 0 for 20, it might be quite a roller coaster ride, and he might have a tough time handling all the adulation. But he's very cool, calm, and has had an unbelievable first week.
We're going to let you go. You got an interview to do. We're going to walk over and enjoy the view a little bit here. Jimmy's going to come. And Len, you go first.
All right.
We'll let Fred show you his view. Fred Washington, the king of the scoreboard, our great friend.
Fred, how are you, bud?
Oh, so far, so good. I think I'll make it.
So what's the key here? I mean, you obviously know all the numbers and where everything is, but how long did it take you to kind of get your bearings in here?
Well, you can't do it overnight. It's just something that comes to you. You just get used to things being backwards, and once you learn it, you don't have to learn it but once. That's it. Then it comes then natural.
And how do you keep track with the out-of-town scores?
Well, Darrell Wilson handles the upstairs where the ticker tape is, and he'll yell down, "Freddie, you have a two in the bottom of the second, bottom game on the American League side," and I'll just get up and go over there and take care of it.
Fred, we're going to ask you one more thing, then we'll let you go. Show us the gesture that everybody in the bleachers is making to you all day about wanting to come up.
Oh, his hand signals. Everybody wants to come up, but if they come up, they may get used to sitting up here. That means I'll be out of a job. A fun job, so.
There you go. Well, he's the most popular guy in Wrigley Field if he would ever open that bottom door, isn't he, Len?
No doubt about it. And we just appreciate you letting us come up here. It's a total honor to be up here.
Hey, well, you're more than welcome.
And all right, thanks, again. Fred.
Thanks, Fred.
Hey, all right, that's going to do it for Len and Bob's podcast. Hopefully Bob will make it to the field in time for his interview. Hopefully we won't lose Len there, Jimmy. As you can see, we may have to drag him back to the broadcast booth later.